Holy Spirit is our reporter. Number two, Holy Spirit is our revealer. The second thing we see about Joseph is that Joseph moves to Egypt. He gets sold for the price of a slave. He goes into Potiphar's home, and from the Potiphar's home, he goes into the dungeon, he goes into jail. And then while he is in jail, the Bible says the man upstairs, Pharaoh, he gets a very unique dream. It's something about cows, it's something about weed, it's something about seven, and he has no idea what this dream is about. He asks all of his magicians, he asks all of the people who translate dreams, he asks all of the sorcerers in his court, all of the scientists, all of the quote-unquote, the religious people, everybody is asked, anybody could help me to translate the dreams. And the Bible says they all go blank, not knowing how to translate the dream. And in the court, there was a young man who says that you need to bring somebody else who is in the dungeon who can translate your dreams for you. And Joseph comes, and Joseph translates the dream that was sent to Pharaoh from God. Now, listen to this. God sends a message to Pharaoh that cannot be decoded without Joseph. God sends a message to Pharaoh, but it cannot be understood without Joseph. So if you don't know Joseph, you will know the message, but not its meaning. The Bible is God's message to you. But the Bible was written with the Holy Ghost, and it cannot be understood without the Holy Spirit. You can know the letter of the Bible, but you will not know the meaning, and you will not get anything out of it without your Joseph. Holy Spirit is the agent that explains and makes the Word of God become, aha, wow, that's deep, that's powerful, that's heavy revy. That is the work of the Holy Ghost. So the first thing about Holy Spirit is he's a reporter. Many people want to have revelations from God's Word, but it starts with respecting the reporter in your heart. You want God to speak to you through his Word? Learn to honor his voice when he speaks to you through his pastor or through your parents. Learn to honor his voice when he speaks as a reporter. And then God begins to reveal his voice through his word. It's interesting, in the Bible it says the Holy Spirit is the breath of God. If you pay attention close to yourself, you will find out something very interesting. You can't speak a word without breathing. If you lose your breathing, you lose your ability to speak. The reason I'm able to pronounce words is because of my breath. If I don't have a breath, I will not have a speech. God cannot speak to you without Holy Spirit. It's the breath, the Spirit of God, that communicates the words of God to you. When we silence and get rid of the breath and we say, well, we just don't need the Holy Spirit, next thing that happens, what comes out from the mouth of God becomes gibberish to us, and it's just the same thing as the dream to Pharaoh. I have no idea what that means. Many people know Greek, they know Latin, and they know Hebrew, and they do not know the voice of God. Because to know the voice of God, you don't have to know Greek, you don't have to know Latin, and you don't have to know Hebrew. You have to know Holy Spirit. When you know Holy Spirit reveals the Word of God to you. Christianity is not a religion. Christianity is a revelation.